Hey guys, it's Brett Williams here to give you a real quick off-the-cuff tutorial on using vertical media in a 16 by 9 project and applying splits to templates to it. It's real simple, but apparently I didn't cover it well enough in the tutorial. There's just a real quick kind of a screen recording there, just talking about it real quick. I thought that'd be enough, but no problem. We're going to go over it real quick here. So I've got a timeline down here that is 1080p, just your basic HD timeline. And over here in the browser, I have this little girl playing ukulele, and she is shot on an iPhone. She's a vertical video. And so first, let's grab the whole thing, drag this down here to the timeline. And of course, it is pillar boxed on the left and right. If I wanted to add, say, this splits four column effect to it, you'd get some mixed results. As you can see, position one is empty. If I change the position presets, and if you need to know more about really just how to use splits, watch the entire tutorial found on the splits 2 page or on my YouTube channel. You see how it kind of... It is not doing the math correctly because, well, it does math based on the aspect ratio of the 16 by 9 project. And it assumes that the clips that you're adding are 16 by 9. And so it divvies it up in such a way that does not work. Okay, so this is not going to work. And even if you move it around in here, see, you still don't get the borders not right and everything. All right, so we're going to delete splits here. I'm even going to delete this from the timeline. We're going to start from scratch. So we first drag her to the timeline. And before we add splits, we want to make this a compound clip. And the easiest way to do that is to press Option G. And we'll name it Ukulele Laying by the Pool. Okay, and we'll just save it there. So now we have this little girl, and she is now a compound clip. And what that does is, as long as you make it a compound clip in the timeline, don't turn it into a compound clip up here in the browser. When you turn it into a compound clip in your project in the timeline, this compound clip will now match the aspect of the timeline. If I press Shift T to turn on the transform controls and go up here to the viewer, you can see, even though it's transparent on the left and right, the entire clip is now 16 by 9. So now we can go ahead. I'm going to press A to turn off the transform controls and go back to the arrow tool, I guess. Now if I add splits for vertical to it, you can see she's centered up right there. And if I change the position preset, all four of them look right. The border's there. You can pan around. Of course, she only has that much to to pan around. She's a vertical. You know, scale it up, whatever you might need. That's it, guys. I hope that helps you use vertical video in an HD timeline with the standard 16 by 9 effects. And so the same would hold true if you were using 16 by 9 video in a vertical timeline and using the splits vertical templates. You would want to compound your 16 by 9 clip before adding the splits vertical templates. So the reverse, basically. That's it. I hope that helps, guys. And if this video is helpful, please consider subscribing to the BretFX YouTube channel, where we've got an increasing number of Final Cut Pro tutorials as well, and BretFX product tutorials and trailers. Have a great day and happy editing.